Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be another dedicated skincare video in which I'm just going to give you like my full and final thoughts, details, reviews, what do I think is worth it, what do I think is not worth it, kind of like a video. And from the title you can tell the brand we've chosen today is Dot & Key. So Dot & Key is this brand which started out as a brand which was making really unique products, very unique skincare and body care products. It had things like underarm masks and underarm serums, and basically those body parts or those particular things that we normally tend to ignore, and ones that don't really have a lot of options. They also have like elbow and knee creams and everything which you won't find in other brands. So they started out with something like that, but now they have a lot of other products as well. They have vitamin C serums, they have hyaluronic acid serums, they have like serums for anti-acne, and then they have basically a lot of things. They have diversified a lot, and I do have a lot of products from this brand. I would like to tell you that I am not going to be reviewing every single product that I own from them. The reason being that I have a lot of products from them, and I will not be able to talk about every single one of them in one specific video, because then the video would be like really, really, really long. Like even today I have 7 products today to talk about, and I still feel like this video is going to be too long, and there are still some things which I feel like I have tried really, really hard to use in the past 2 months. Like all these products I've been trying and testing out for 2 months at this point, and I still feel like I have still not been able to try and test out some other products which I feel like I don't have my full and final thoughts on them yet, because maybe I have not been able to use them enough in 2 months, and I have not been able to like give you like make up my mind and give you my final thoughts about them. So those I will continue trying and testing out, and ever since I bought these products, I feel like they have launched a few new products which I'm also interested, so I will eventually purchase them as well. So I'll probably do like a part 2 video on Dot & Key skincare, like a Dot & Key skincare review part 2. In those I'll talk about the new products, and then ones which I already have which I have not been able to figure out my final thoughts on them, I will continue trying and testing them out, and in that video I will share a review on those as well. So I will review them, just not right now, because I don't feel comfortable talking about something that I don't have my final thoughts on. So yeah, I just wanted to share that disclaimer. The video is really long, but I wanted to share my disclaimer on that as well, just in case you were interested. So the underarm mask, the underarm serum, the elbow and knee cream, what else, the face mask, the yellow tub, I don't remember what the name is, I think it's the tan minimalizing mask or something like that, it's a clay mask, that one as well, what else, those are things which I have, but then I don't have a final thoughts on them. And then they have some moisturizers, eye creams, which I have not got my hands on, so we'll get my hands on them, and then we'll do like a part 2 video. But today I'm going to talk about the Skin Awakening Moisture Boost Serum, I'm going to talk about the Matte Finish Moisturizer and Serum, I'm going to talk about the Night Serum, I'm going to talk about the Vitamin C Serum, the Hyaluronic Acid Serum, the Zig Zapping Skin Clarifying Face Serum, and the Hair Serum. So yeah, without any further ado, let's get started, and I will leave timestamps for every single product, because I feel like this video is going to be very long, and if you are looking for like one specific part of the video and you want to see a review on maybe like some specific products, then I think the timestamps would be helpful. So I will leave timestamps in the description box, just in case you're interested. So yeah, now let's finally get started. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is the Dot & Key Matte Finish Moisturizer and Serum. So this is what the packaging looks like. You do get like an outer cardboard box as well, but I haven't saved that. But yeah, this is what the packaging looks like. It's super duper cute, and every single product has like different colors and everything. So, oops, I just dropped the bottle of the hair serum. But yeah, they do have very colorful packaging, and I think it looks really nice and cute. So yeah, that is something I just want to throw out there. But yeah, this is what it looks like, and it's a pump packaging, which I do really like. So first of all, I'll show you what the texture of the product is like. So when you pump it out, this is what it looks like, and this is how much you get in one pump. So normally I take around two or three pumps of this, and the consistency is very nice and lightweight. I think it's suitable for oily skin and for normal skin as well, combination skin as well. But if you have dry skin, I think it's not going to be moisturizing enough for you. And I don't think this is like targeted for dry skin any which ways, because it says it's a matte moisturizer, so it definitely leaves a matte finish on the skin. Not like a complete matte finish, like not like a powder matte, but when they say it's a matte moisturizer, what it basically means, it's very lightweight, it's going to get absorbed into the skin, and it's not going to leave like an oily greasy film on skin whatsoever. So yeah, this is how it looks like when it's completely moisturized. You cannot tell on the skin. So again, if you have normal combination oily skin, it's a really good option, because it's not going to leave you looking oily or greasy whatsoever, and that's something we don't really like when you have combination oily skin. So yeah, that was that. Now, do I think that this is really worth it? Like, personally, this has a very strong fragrance. That is one thing that I don't like about it. So like, let's start talking about pros and cons. So one of the pros is, again, that it's a very nice lightweight moisturizer, doesn't leave an oily greasy film whatsoever on skin. Talking about the cons, it does have a strong fragrance. I wish that they could not have I mean, I know it's the natural extracts, it's not artificial fragrance that they have put in, because they do mention that all of the products are free from dyes and sulfates, parabens. The outer packaging has like a card which mentions all of this, so yeah, they don't have any artificial dyes or chemicals or fragrance. But yeah, it is natural fragrance, which is it's a fragrance which is a mixture of lavender and tea tree. So yeah, I wish that the fragrance was not so I mean, it is definitely strong. It's not something that is super duper bothering, but yeah, it's something that you should do keep in mind, that it does smell like quite a bit when you apply it. It's not going to stay on, or you're not going to feel the smell like throughout the day, but it is something to keep in mind. So yeah, the fragrance is something that is definitely a little bit harsh and a little bit strong. Another thing is the price point. Now, this is not supposed to, like, it doesn't have vitamin C. It's not going to brighten up your skin or, you know, do something extraordinary for the skin. It's just a regular moisturizer. And I feel like you can find a regular moisturizer like this, like, I feel like I compare everything to the Pond's Gel Moisturizer, but that one is again a lot more lightweight in terms of consistency, very similar, again, great for normal and combination oily skin, and again, something that it's not very oily or greasy or heavy, so it's a very good affordable dupe for this, even though it's different in terms of consistency. Like, this is a cream that is matte, and that is more of like a gel moisturizer, so again, different consistencies. But then again, I feel like the results that you get and the kind of audience and skin type that it is catering to is very, very similar. And this is a lot more expensive as compared to that one. That one is so much more affordable. So I think for that reason, of course, now that one I believe does have parabens and sulfates and phthalates and blah, 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 chemicals and all of that. But yeah, it kind of depends. If you want something that is free of parabens and sulfates and artificial chemicals and everything, then you can definitely go for this. It is a good product if you don't mind the fragrance. But for the price point, I feel like this is not something that I would go ahead and repurchase over and over again and make it like my holy grail moisturizer, only because it is more expensive as compared to that one. So yeah, those were my thoughts, and you can decide what you would want to do, which one you would want to pick. But yeah, it is a good product, it's just a little bit more expensive and does not do anything extraordinary, life-changing, which is why I wouldn't repurchase it. So that was that. Moving on next to, let's talk about the hair serum quickly, because this is one which I feel like I've used the most out of every single product I've tried and tested out, because this one I've had for a very long time. I've used it since the past 2 months. I've used it before that as well. This is the hair serum, which also has sunscreen in it, so it's supposed to protect the hair again from the UVA and UVB rays. So this is one that again does have a fragrance. It's a little bit more on the stronger side, and you can feel it once, like when you first apply it. My hair is a little bit damp, so I'll just quickly apply a little bit and show you. I think that will be a good way to demonstrate it as well. I thought of this right now, I swear. It was not planned. So I will take around 4 to 5 pumps of this. There isn't much left in this, which is why I took 4 to 5 pumps. Otherwise, I would have taken like maybe 2 pumps. and I will quickly massage this, focusing more on the bottom part of my hair. So it leaves a nice shine, nice fragrance as well. A little bit more strong. I would prefer something more milder, like maybe the fragrance of Livon or something like that. A little bit more mild. This is a little bit more stronger. But this is a product that I actually do really like. I don't think, again, I would go ahead and repurchase it as such. But I did really, really enjoy using it. Actually, to be honest, I might repurchase this because I don't think I've ever been blown away by a serum as much as I've been impressed by this one. So yeah, I think this one, there is a possibility that if Dotton K had like 20% off or 25% off on Nykaa, then I would probably go ahead and repurchase this one along with some of the other products. So yeah, that would be my thoughts on this one. Moving on, next is the Skin Awakening Moisture Boost Serum. So this is what it looks like. Again, it's got a green packaging, similar again pump. Now this one again looks like more of a cream. This is one pump. It's got a very similar consistency. Once you massage this, it gets very quickly absorbed into the skin. And it's a nice moisturizing serum if you have dry skin. Maybe even dry combination or combination skin, normal oily skin. I think this one is suitable for quite a few skin types. If you have very dry skin, then I'm not sure this is going to be moisturizing enough. But yeah, now this one is specifically mentioned you're supposed to use this in the daytime. And I do agree with that because it's not super duper hydrating for nighttime. It's definitely something that is going to be more suitable for using it in the daytime. But again, it's not something, even though, again, my thoughts on this one are kind of similar to what my thoughts are on the moisturizer, where I mentioned that it's something very normal, generic. It's not something extraordinary. It's supposed to be a nice moisturizing serum, but apart from that, it doesn't really do much. There are not really any other benefits, and I feel like if you are using a good moisturizer, you don't really need a serum that is also going to be extremely moisturizing, because the moisturizer is going to be moisturizing any which ways, right? I feel like I'm saying moisture and moisturizing like a lot of times, but this product doesn't really just make much sense in the routine. I would rather add like a vitamin C serum in place of this and then use a moisturizer on top. And I feel like that combination will do a lot more for my skin rather than this would do with another moisturizer just like this. It's just like a more thinner, lightweight like option for a moisturizer. Like that is what this one feels like. Again, it's got a scent as well. I feel like I'm putting everything in the same hand, so the scent of everything is going to like mix up. But I know what this smells like, and I can definitely smell it. It smells like it's got peppermint and lavender in this. So yeah, it does have that really herbally kind of a fragrance. But yeah, again, this product doesn't really make a lot of sense to me. I will use up the entire bottle, but I don't think I would go ahead and repurchase this or very highly recommend this as well. I know it doesn't sound like the most positive review, but trust me, the best is yet to come. I'm saving the best and some of my absolute favorite products for the last. So yeah, that was that. These were all the okay, so some good kind of reviews, and now we're gonna move on to some of my favorite products from the brand. So this part I'm super duper excited about. So the first thing that I want to talk about is the Dotton Key Skin Essentials Night Serum. So this one is, it's got peony and verbena, I think that's how you say it. So it's supposed to be a 3-in-1 formulation that hydrates, lightens and prevents aging of facial skin. Now that I don't really agree with much. I have not seen really much of like a lightening or a brightening or like just miraculous results in general. Not really. But First of all, I think the packaging is super duper cute. It's a great serum if you want something to travel with. This is something that I took with me on travel, and this is one of the products I use literally day and night. I know it's supposed to be specifically like a night serum, but I did use this in the daytime as well and didn't really have any problem or something with that. I was basically living in snow and my skin was so dry that I needed something to use. And I don't think that this is going to be suitable in like a very, very cold temperature. But if you're someone who's living in like a metro city or something like that and you have dry skin, then I do think this is a good option because it will work. That is something that I personally feel, but of course if the climate is super duper extreme, then it's not going to be good enough. That is something that you do need to keep in mind, so keep that in mind. But yeah, this is something that I did really enjoy using because I feel like this is a good night serum or like a good facial oil kind of product to use if you have normal to combination skin, because it's very lightweight, feels really good and gets absorbed very, very quickly into the skin. It does moisturize the skin a lot but does not feel really oily, heavy and greasy. And I feel like a lot of facial oils and serums that I have used definitely feel a lot more heavy and greasy on the skin, and that's something I don't always like. I don't like something that is very, very heavy or thick and like feels like a lot on the skin. Sometimes it's good when my skin is like really, 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 really dry, but otherwise I like something which is a lot more like lightweight on the skin, and this is something like that. The only con I feel like particularly with this product is going to be that you don't get a lot of product for the amount of money that you're paying. So it's priced at ₹595, so 600 for 15 ml only. Now you can definitely get like a 30 ml bottle for this much amount of money, so I feel like it's almost double the cost. So it's going to be more expensive, but if you want something just to splurge in the winters when your skin is very, very dry or like relatively dry, and you want like a good facial oil, like a serum sort of product which is not going to be very, very oily, thick and heavy on the skin, it's something you can definitely consider and something you can go ahead and check out. So yeah, this is a product that I do really like and recommend as well. If I had to go ahead and repurchase like a facial oil or something for winters, this is one of the options that I would consider for sure. So yeah, this is a product that I would definitely recommend. So yeah, that was that. Was just making sure that I did not really make a mistake with the price or anything, because I do feel like that is again one of the kind of selling points as to if you want to go ahead and repurchase this or not. Also, I'm sorry, I'm playing with my hair, it's actually wet, so kind of bothering me, but yeah. Now moving on next to three of my absolutely favorite products from this brand, and it is these three serums. I totally dropped it and let me go grab it. So yeah, these are three of my absolute favorite products. It looks so pretty and colorful when I place it like this, but yeah, these are my three absolute most favorite products from the brand. So we have the Water Drenched Hydrating Hyaluronic Serum Concentrate, we have the Zit Zapping Skin Clarifying Face Serum, and we have the Glow Revealing Vitamin C Serum Concentrate. So I will talk about all three of them one by one. I'm going to talk about this one first because I feel like this is kind of like a different product. And then these two I will talk about together. So we'll talk about this one first. This is probably my favorite product to use when my skin is breaking out or I have bumps or like pimples or acne on my skin. I have been breaking out in the past 2 months, like every once in a while, here and there. And every single time that I use this, I feel like my pimples clear up super duper quickly. Maybe in like 2 or 3 days max when I'm using this twice in a day. I do use it twice in a day, I will tell you. So when my skin is breaking out, I will skip the vitamin C or like the other serums and I will use this one only to make sure that it really gets rid of it as soon as possible. And I have seen some absolutely great results with this. So if you have oily acne prone skin, highly, highly, highly recommend that you have to check out this product, because it's definitely going to make a difference to your skin. Also, what I really like about this is the consistency. So a lot of times, like one of my favorite like anti-acne serums is by Juicy Chemistry, and that one I feel like I can use only in the nighttime because it's a very thick oil kind of a serum. It definitely helps a lot with acne and pimples, but it's a very thick oil kind of a product and it's very thick on the skin, like very heavy and oily. But this one, I have put like a small dot, if you can see right here. It's transparent, so you can't see much. But this is literally like water. The consistency is so thin. It's literally like water. And it gets absorbed very, very, very quickly into the skin, which is why you can use it both morning and night. And that's something I really, 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 really like about this. I also did not show you the consistency of the night serum. So, I will quickly show you that as well. Again, it's a clear serum. It's more on the runny side. Can you see? It literally just ran down my hand. But yeah, it's very, very lightweight. I know it's transparent, which is why you can't see much. But it literally feels like nothing in the skin, which is something I absolutely freakingly love about it. So yeah, just wanted to show you that once again because I forgot to show it to you earlier. But yeah, that was that. Oops, I was almost about to drop this because I hadn't shut it. But yeah, this is something I would again highly, highly, highly recommend. If you have oily acne prone skin, definitely check it out. Definitely get it. Moving on, next we will talk about these two. Now these I feel like are kind of a little bit similar to each other, but I will tell you why I'm saying that they're similar to each other. So basically, we'll talk about this one first because this is literally my absolute favorite product from the entire range, and every single product that I spoke about right now, or I'm going to speak about, this is one of my favorites. So this is like a close second, but this is something I would only recommend if you have oily acne prone skin. If you don't break out, this product is going to make absolutely no sense to you and it's not meant for you. But this is something, no matter what your skin type is, no matter what your skin concern is, I think you should definitely, definitely, definitely check it out. Only if you have dry or very dry skin, I feel like this is not the most ideal option for you. And I would recommend the what is that brand? Yeah, the Mixify Unlock Serum, the what is it called? Glow something serum. It's basically the red color bottle. So they have a red, they have a green, and they have a blue. So the red color serum is what I'm talking about. If you have dry or very dry skin, I think that is one that I would recommend more than this one. But if you have combination, normal or oily skin, this is the vitamin C serum that I would recommend. You definitely, definitely, definitely have to check out. If you have acne marks as well, I think this is going to be really helpful for you because I have been using it since the past 2 months. And I don't know how well you can tell, but I am right here. Like, I am literally here, like, where the orange line is. That is where I am. Now, I have not used this for 2 months every single day because, again, I have used this one as well. So, that is something I will tell you. And this one, I have used this much. I have used exactly half of this. Whereas this one, I am almost about to run out of. So, this is something I have definitely used a lot more and I have seen some absolutely amazing results with this one. My skin looks a lot more brighter, a lot more even toned. The pimple marks that I basically have on my skin, I feel like they have been a lot lighter ever since I have been using these. I've seen a great, great, great difference in those as well. And I definitely know that I have to owe it all to this particular product. It's absolutely amazing. If you feel like your skin is dull, if you feel like your skin is not bright enough, if you feel like you need to do something about the pimple marks and the acne marks that you have, but nothing is working, nothing is helping in lightening them, go ahead and check this one out. It's definitely going to make a difference for sure. Also, the consistency of this one is very, very similar to the Zip Zapping Serum. It is clear and it is very, very light. Gets absorbed very, very quickly into the skin. I use around 3 drops of this. One on my forehead, one on each cheek. And it's absolutely perfect. I would use this only in the daytime, not really in the nighttime. Because I think daytime is to use a vitamin C serum. And then nighttime is to use like AHAs and BHAs and all of that. So yeah, they do recommend that you use this twice in a day. But I think if I want to have like a stable routine for the rest of my life, I would use a vitamin C serum only in the daytime. And then I would use an AHA, BHA serum only in the nighttime. So that is something which I feel is more ideal, even though they do mention that you should be using this twice a day. So yeah, that's something I want to put out there. If you feel like you don't have skin texture, if you feel like you don't need an AHA, BHA serum, but you have a lot of problems when it comes to dull skin and you have a lot of pigmentation or like acne marks, and you want to do something to get rid of them really soon because maybe you have like a wedding coming up in the next 2-3 months or something, or basically you want to get rid of them as soon as possible, then yeah, maybe you could use this twice in a day and see good results and faster results. So yeah, that's something I want to mention you keep in mind. So yeah, this is something I would highly, highly, highly recommend. Definitely need to get. Now, this particular one I feel like is going to be again more suitable for a similar skin type. But if you have very dehydrated skin, now dry skin and dehydrated skin are two different things. If you feel like you don't drink enough water, and which is why your skin is very dehydrated, and you need something that has hyaluronic acid to bring hydration to your skin more than moisturization, that is when a serum like this comes in the picture. So again, suitable for I think pretty much a similar range of skin types. Again, like I mentioned, dehydrated skin mainly, but otherwise normal, combination, and oily skin. None of these I feel like are more suitable for very, very dry skin or dry skin. Apart from this one, I feel like it is suitable for dry skin, but not like very, very dry skin. So again, this is the Hyaluronic Serum Concentrate. Very similar in terms of consistency, but this one also has vitamin C. It's a vitamin C induced formula. Again, very, very similar in terms of consistency, like I mentioned. So this is a vitamin C induced formula, which is why I feel like if you have the kind of skin where it is dehydrated, but then you also somewhere want to add vitamin C to your routine, and you feel like maybe you have some pigmentation, hyperpigmentation, and you want to use vitamin C to help with that, then I think that this would be the more ideal option for you to go for, rather than going for this one. If it is, if your pigmentation or hyperpigmentation is more on the severe side and you want faster results, then this has a higher concentration of vitamin C, because this is majorly a vitamin C serum, which is also a little bit hydrating because of what the consistency is like. But this is the hydrating serum which has a small amount of vitamin C in it. So basically, if dehydration is what you're facing and you want some vitamin C, you should be going for this. If pigmentation is your main concern and you also want some hydration, then this is what you should be going for. So I hope I'm making the distinguish very clear as to what is more suitable for what. Like if your skin type is, that will be able to make a more informed choice as to what you want to go for. Considering what my skin type is, I feel like this is more of an like ideal option for me, because I do have other hydrating moisturizers which I can use paired with this. Like maybe this with like the Pond's moisturizer is like literally match made in heaven for me. So that is more of like an ideal combination that I would want to go for, because I feel like it would make more sense. But then again, if I were using maybe like this moisturizer, then I would pair something like this and then put this one on top, and this would be a more ideal combination. So yeah, that was majorly about what product is supposed to do, what I'm really fond of, which ones I would recommend, which ones I wouldn't recommend. If you have any more questions, you can definitely leave them in the comment section. I would love to chat with you guys about all these products. So again, those were all my thoughts and everything. I feel like I've been talking so much for pretty much almost half an hour. So yeah, I really hope that you found this video helpful and you enjoyed watching it. The next brand that we would be focusing for the next 2 months on is Toli Moly. I have a lot of products from them once again, which I will be trying and testing out for the next 2 months. And after 2 months, I will come back and do a similar video just like this on Toli Moly and share my review on all of their skincare products. So yeah, definitely keep your eye out on that, just in case if you're interested. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Please do subscribe to my channel and also hit the bell button, because that will get to know every single time I post a new video. Your support means everything to me, and only because of you guys' support I've been doing whatever I'm doing. So yeah, thank you so much. Specifically, I want to thank all of you, because I think that these brand reviews are what do really, really well in my channel and what you guys love watching the most. Thank you so much for all of the support that you guys show me on these videos. I honestly can't thank you guys enough. So yeah, that I want to quickly sign off. Thank you so much for watching this video. I will leave links to everything, like all the products I mentioned today, in this video in the description box, just in case you're interested in checking any of them out. You definitely do so. And yeah, that is pretty much it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. Until next time, bye.